Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about hemophagocytic lymphohistiocytosis imaging. This is a rare disorder of pathological immune activation resulting in systemic hyperinflammation. Likely to represent Y spectrum divided into types. Genetic primary familial inherited genetic abnormality. Acquired secondary environmental or acquired mechanisms such as infection, malignancy, autoimmune condition, and immunocompromise. Most common signs symptoms can be multisystemic and so wide variation, difficult to differentiate from more common disease. Infections are often triggered, especially herpes and Epstein-Barr virus group. When associated with malignancy, they are most commonly hematologic in nature. In adult, malignancy is thought to be most common trigger, but is much less common in pediatric. Immunosuppression is also recognized as predisposition to HLH. When HLH is related to autoimmune disease, most commonly systemic onset GIA and SLE, it is referred to HMAS. Systemic fever, coagulopathy, cytopenia, multi-organ failure, lymphadenopathy, hyperferritinemia. CNS tends to be persistent systemic finding but are present in 1.5% of patients with HLH. Wide range headache, vomiting, psychiatric symptoms, dystonia, hemiparesis, visual disturbance, cognitive decline, seizure, cranial nerve palsy, encephalopathy, ataxia, gait disturbance, increased intracranial pressure, coma, abdominal jaundice, hepatitis, liver dysfunction, failure, hepatosplenomegaly, MSK, skin rash, edema. Demography. Primary HLH usually present within first few years of life. Some cases of adult onset have been reported. Secondary HLH can occur at any age. Initial presentation is usually associated with infection, autoimmune condition, or malignancy. Majority of adult HLH patients do not demonstrate underlying immune defects. Incidence is slightly underestimated. A retrospective study performed in Sweden estimates incidence of 1.241 million children per year. More recent retrospective study performed in Texas suggests prevalence of 1 over 100,000 with median age at diagnosis of 1.8 years. Imaging non-specific findings used to assess and monitor disease activity and respond to treatment. Cheratograph, abdominal ultrasound, brain MRI are often obtained during workup based on signs and symptoms. Recent papers suggest consider of PEPs to detect acute lymphoma. No standard protocol exists. Thoracic finding, alveolar opacity, interstitial thickening, arthritis, volume loss, pleural effusion, chemotherapy can show a rapid evolution and resolution. Abdominal finding, hepatosplenomegaly, nephromegaly, and increased periportal echogenicity, hyperechoic kidney, gallbladder wall thickening, ascites. CNS finding, multiple T2 hyperintense lesion plus minus contrast enhancement, edema, volume loss, generalized lymphadenopathy. Axial flare in a 9-year-old boy presenting with progressive headache, vomiting, and unsteady over the past 3 months, so numerous hypertension, cortical, subcortical, and deep lesion within the brain parenchyma. He was subsequently found to have a familial HLH. Chest radiograph in an ill child with HLH, so ill-defined perifinal opacity, right, worse than left. Grayscale ultrasound in a 9-year-old patient with HLH, so splenomegaly measuring up to 13.9 cm, while non-specificity is a common finding in HLH. Grayscale ultrasounds in a child with HLH, so the right lobe of liver extending far below the inferior pole of the kidney, suggesting hepatomegaly and a common but non-specific finding in disorder. Ultrasound in a patient shows an enlarged kidney with increased eccentricity of the renal cortex and increased hepatic periportal eccentricity. Treatment goal is to dampen cytokine storm and eliminate activated T cells and macrophages, immune suppressive chemotherapeutic drugs, and biologic dexamethasone, ectoposide, and cyclosporine A. Intratectal methotrexate for CNS involvement. Treatment of underlying trigger. Allogeneic stem cell transplantation is only cure for primary and familial HLH. Thank you.